Today we're going to go over the difference between the squat jerk or the push jerk and the split jerk. In order to do that, we need to talk a little bit about different body types. So in weightlifting, it tends to be that people that have very long torsos and very short limbs make good weightlifters for a whole lot of reasons. One reason is that if you have short legs and a very long spine, then you tend to be a very good squatter. You have very good leverage for squatting. One reason is because as you squat down with your short limbs, it doesn't take you as long to go up and to go down, so you have to work against gravity less. Number two, having that nice long spine lets you stay a lot more vertical than you would if you had a shorter spine. It also makes you a bad deadlifter because you have a very long lever arm, but for squatting, it tends to be very beneficial. Likewise, if you have very short limbs, when you go to jerk or to snatch, you don't have to throw it as high above your head, so you don't have to throw it with quite as much force because it doesn't have to go the same distance as someone who has longer arms. So in order to be a good squat jerker, then you need to be able to have, number one, either very good mobility, or number two, you have to have, in addition to good mobility, you have to have a body type that will benefit from that type of jerk. A lot of people don't have that type of body type, and you rarely see people that don't have the same mobility and a long back and short torsos that are good squat jerkers. Those people are going to have to stick with a split jerk. So we'll show you real quick the difference between the two. All of the principles are generally the same. We go to do the jerk, whether you do a split jerk or a squat jerk, you're going to dip, keep your elbows high, heels on the ground. From here, I'm going to jump as high as I can and then push myself under the bar. So I'm here, I jump up, and then I push myself under the bar until I have locked out elbows. If I throw the weight this high, then I need to push myself down until I have locked out elbows and then stand. So throw the weight as high as you can and then push yourself down until your elbows are locked out straight. For a squat jerk, even though I have decent mobility, I do not have good leverage to do squat jerks. I would probably never squat jerk in competition. So I'm here. That's about the best I can do right here. A pretty vertical back, pull my bar over my body. I do not have good leverage for that at all. We'll come back tomorrow. We'll give you a few more details about the squat jerk. See you then.